September 11th, 2001, dawned over Offutt Air Force Base as it did for most of us, clear and calm. Deep in this building, the U.S. Strategic Command, or STRATCOM, was in the middle of a global exercise, coordinating its bombers, missiles, and submarines around the world. Every seat in the command center would be taken.
We were fully ready that day.
But no one was ready for this. About 8:45 Eastern Time, American Airlines Flight 11 hits the North Tower of the World Trade Center. Rear Admiral Jay Donnelly, second in command at STRATCOM, starts moving.
So I came down to the command center immediately, and we began, in addition to our exercise responsibilities, began also monitoring the events as they were unfolding on the network news.
Then, 9:03, United Flight 175 slams into the South Tower.
Oh my God!
When the second plane hit the World Trade Center, we made an immediate decision to terminate our exercise because we realized that our country was under attack and made that transition immediately into the real world events.
In Florida, President Bush is reading to an elementary class when Chief of Staff Andrew Card whispers to him the stunning news. 9:40, part of the Pentagon's now in flames after Flight 77 crashes into it. Then, 10:30, hijacked Flight 93 goes down in a field near Shanksville, Pennsylvania. Offutt, like all U.S. bases, goes into its highest threat condition level. Extra guards checking every vehicle very closely.
At that time, we did not really know the extent to which the terrorist attacks might unfold.
Down here in the underground, a contrast to the madness outside. A steady but quiet buzz of activity.
People were on all these phones. They were having very quiet conversations. They were gathering information from all the sources that we have at our disposal.
Sources like military, government, and civilian leaders around the world. Offutt is known for its security and its extensive communications abilities. So a presidential stop here was possible, if not probable. And just before 1:30 local time, STRATCOM gets a quick heads up. The president is on his way.
We had approximately a 30-minute warning.
Just before 2 o'clock.
Good afternoon. I'm Rob McCartney in the KETV Newsplex. We are breaking in for a brief update on what's happening here in the heartland. Air Force One has landed at Offutt Air Force Base.
President Bush is greeted by then-STRATCOM Chief Admiral Richard Meigs. The president's entourage immediately heads to the underground. Now, our cameras are the first allowed to show you exactly where he went. Down a series of halls, through security checkpoints, to STRATCOM's command center.
Where was the president in all this?
The president sat in this seat right here. And Mr. Andrew Card sat next to him, the White House Chief of Staff. And I was in this seat next to Mr. Card.
The president is put on a telephone conference call with his senior staff while he gets briefed on the latest.
He utilized these screens, or we utilized these screens behind me to project all the information that we had at the time.
Information on the hijacked planes, on the status of all flights in American airspace, on American forces.
We were able to summarize all the reports we were receiving in that conference call I mentioned earlier.
And Donnelly says, through it all, the president was all business.
He was very serious, but he was very calm, and he was very much in control.
After 25 minutes, President Bush decides he needs a video meeting. STRATCOM has a special place for that. So back through more underground hallways to this room, where it's need to know only.
Now, the president spent a majority of his time, more than an hour, here in the VTC, the video teleconference room. He sat right here in this chair, hooked up to the White House, the Pentagon, and other government agencies.
Now, the meeting was classified, so all the details may never be known. But during the video conference, the president reportedly said, "We will find these people." And after getting all the information he needed, told everyone, "Ladies and gentlemen, I'm coming home." So, at 3:36 Central Time, Air Force One heads back to Washington, D.C. His stay at Offutt, just 90 minutes.
The time was short, but I think he got exactly what he needed.
And he left behind words of inspiration that Admiral Donnelly says no one in this room will probably ever forget.
He looked and he made eye contact with every man and woman in this room, and he took the time and he said, "I want all of you in this room to know that what you do for your country is important, and we need you more now. Your country needs you more now than it ever has before. Thank you." And then he left, and you could have heard a pin drop. Really impressive.
Now, a year later, and the immediate threat over, Admiral Donnelly reflects on how he felt that day. Not as a high-ranking military officer, but as an American.
You know, when I think back on that day, I'm still angry.
And beyond the anger,
sorrow for all of the lives that we were watching on the screens being taken, and the families and all the loved ones associated with them.